what to see, what to stream, and what to skip. It's Movie Reviews with Ryan J.
He looks good in that picture, doesn't he? It is Friday. That means film critic Ryan J is here to review movies coming out this weekend.
Hey, Ryan.
Hi, guys. How's it going?
Good.
Anything special you want to say?
I do. Before we begin today, I want to give a special shout out to my dad because he's turning 75. It's his birthday.
Today.
There he is, taking a picture. Say hi, Dad. To your left, Dad. To your left.
Go to your left.
There you go.
There he is.
He's the best.
Guy.
He's the best. I love you, Dad.
That's
and he's the most supportive and coolest guy I know. So happy 75.
We love you, Mike. Yeah. Happy,
all
birthday.
I do, happy birthday.
He's so cute.
He is. He's the greatest.
He is
so
great.
I'm lucky.
You know what's not cute?
What?
This movie you're going to review.
Yeah. Why?
Because it's awful. It's called It, and it's rated R, and I'm a little nervous about liking
it. No, I think you'd like it. I think you should go see this movie. It's not scary. It's not scary at all.
Winkity wink.
Yeah, you should see this.
Right. Okay, so I think I told you this, but I saw The Rock, you know, who posted about this saying, like, it's, like, incredible. It redefines the genre. I want to know a little bit about It and what
well,
it is.
Yeah.
I'm not ever going to see it. So
I agree with Dwayne Johnson, but basically, this is the first big cinematic adaptation of Stephen King's classic novel, It. It was made for TV in 1990.
Look at the face behind your shoulder. Here, lean to your right.
Oh, there we go.
Lean to your right.
Oh, my right? My left?
Right.
Oh, my right.
There, now we can see.
Now we can see
the face now.
That's Pennywise, and the actor who plays him is actually really hot.
Oh God, that's creepy.
But the
gross.
So this is the big screen adaptation, and it's so cool. I didn't see the TV version in 1990 because I wanted to kind of wait and see how this was going to be as its own entertainment, not compare it to anything what to expect. So
Yeah,
it's really fun.
All right,
it's a fun movie.
Is it a mashup reminder?
It is. It reminds me a lot of, like, The Goonies and Stand By Me, Married to Stranger Things, you know, striking while the iron is hot right now with Stranger Things, very 80s nostalgia. It's shot as though Steven Spielberg could have filmed this. It pays homage to a lot of his framing and his cinematography sensibilities. And it is just a very, very fun, scary movie.
Okay, how scary is it?
It is scary. I mean, it's
creepy. On a scale of one to pee your pants.
It's creepier than it is scary. But it's also really fun. And I think what The Rock was talking about, how it redefines horror, is because, like, when Marvel came along and redefined superhero movies, they were action films that brought in a lot of great comedy. And here, the comedy isn't like Chucky. It's not cheesy and wasted.
Okay.
It's really great, strong comedy that doesn't break the suspense, horror, or action. These kids are magnificent. One of them is from Stranger Things. Their chemistry is magnificent. Like, it's rated R. I almost wish that 13-year-olds could go see this movie because
I don't.
It's just like how they act, though. It's how they bully and how they speak to each other. And it took me right back to childhood and middle school.
Oh, really?
Absolutely.
Oh, that's awful.
Did you have some PTSD?
Did you have fear tears?
No fear tears in this one, but I gasped and, you know, I jumped in all the right places, but I was really having a good time. This is like a keeper. This is up there with The Shining and Misery among Stephen King's best, and they're already working on part two.
No, gross.
See it.
Don't ever see it.
See it. All right, Home Again, PG-13.
Yeah, now this is a romantic comedy, and romantic comedies have changed. You know, classic rom-coms don't really work anymore. We don't see the flavor of Meg Ryan and Julia Roberts. And now I think audiences want something that has a dose of reality and a dose of drama to it as well. So I call these nouveau rom-coms. This follows that formula, and it works really well.
Okay.
Reese Witherspoon.
And it's funny. I've seen a lot of interviews with her recently. Mm-hmm. It looks like that's her daughter. Is that her daughter, by the way?
I don't know if that's her real life daughter.
It does look
like her daughter, Ava. Okay, sorry. Anyway, who directed this?
Well, this is written and directed by Hallie Myers Shire, who is, interestingly, the daughter of Nancy Myers, who directed What Women Want, and the daughter of Charles Shire, who directed Father of the Bride. So her mother and father are, you know, directed some of the most classic rom-coms in history. So she had a lot of help, I'm sure, from mom and dad on this movie, but to her credit, it all works.
And what happens in it? Can you share?
Sure. Reese plays a mother of two who leaves her husband, played by Michael Sheen, in New York. They're separated. She goes out to L.A., home again to L.A. You find out in the film why she left him. And then while she's in L.A., she hooks up with, there you see him, this guy who's 13 years younger. It's not cliche. Their chemistry is real. I was feeling it. I was laughing out loud. I was welling up with tears out of heartache. I was feeling this movie. And the soundtrack is so good.
Like, really?
It's the first time I saw a movie in like that I can remember where I want to buy the soundtrack because every song in that film is like something I want.
Huh. Okay, so this is good?
Yeah, see it.
See it?
See it. Great, great.
I love Reese Witherspoon.
Rom-com. Finally a good rom-com.
Okay. Oh, mm-hmm. I like that. All right, the next one, I don't know how to say it.
It's Menasha.
That's what I thought.
Right, and it is a Yiddish language film in English subtitles, and it's about a Hasidic Jew in Brooklyn who's struggling to raise his son on his own.
PG, okay. Right?
Mm-hmm, it's rated PG.
Human right. story, good elements?
It is. Well, it is human in the sense that it's very realistic. It's steeped in a difficult life changes and things that this guy is going through, and you may be able to relate to them or not. But what's interesting here is that the community, the Hasidic community that he lives with, they have their own set of laws when it comes to child rearing that he has to obey, mm-hmm. almost like a cult level, because it's like if you don't want to obey by those, you'd be like rejected by the community or something like that. So that's very interesting to see in this film.
All right, see it, stream it, skip
I'd say
it.
Skip it.
Okay.
Because it leaves you feeling empty, it's slow, it's boring, it's depressing, and the whole time I was like, ugh, I didn't like how I felt.
So I don't like that.
Thank you.
Don't
tell us
your
to
time.
Skip it
yeah.
then. Uh-huh. 60 Yard Line.
60 Yard Line is a special film, locally made and produced. It is a rom-com for dudes because
oh.
the
Nuh-uh.
romance, it's a comedy, and the romance is between a guy and the Green Bay Packers.
No way! That's
yes.
great!
Amazing!
It's pretty cool.
Did anybody make any cameos in it?
Oh, there are a lot of Packers in this movie.
Really?
A lot of fun. It was shot at Lambeau and surrounding area in Green Bay. You'll recognize a lot of locations. You know, I love sports movies usually because there's that aspect of, you know, the field and the team and
yeah.
what they're going through and the underdog story. This doesn't have that because this focuses more on relationships, but it is quite funny and it's great seeing the cameos. And I like how the look of it is very Coen Brothers. It
oh.
has a witty, clever, sarcastic kind of attitude to it. Like,
did they get the
Wisconsin narrator.
Accent correct?
Well, it's a little bit more Fargo than Wisconsin.
Okay.
That was the only drawback I'd say that irritated me in this movie. But aside from that, it's great and see it. It's going to be at Marcus Theaters this weekend, starting today.
Just this weekend?
No, it's distributed in actually 15 states. And
okay,
so
okay.
it's going to be around this weekend, maybe extended, you know, if people get out and see it. So
all right.
it's a fun one. And if you like the Packers, you're going to love this movie.
I like
all
it.
Right, only
okay.
if.
Well,
okay.
and even if you don't, I mean, it's still fun. It's a fun, good
That's
comedy.
Awesome.
Yeah.
What an interesting
it.
Mix of movies today.
Yeah.
It is, yeah, it's
I
really good.
Was like everything, a little bit
Some
of everything
yeah, genres,
in this.
Absolutely.
I love it.
Good.
No movie club to announce today?
No, I have one next week, though, that I'm very excited about. So we'll hold
okay.
on to that for next week.
Teaser.
Sounds good. All right. You can like Ryan J on Facebook, follow him on Instagram and Twitter for his full movie reviews. Be sure to check out his website, ryanjreviews.com. And again, happy birthday to your dad.
Yeah,
thank you so much.
Awesome.
We're celebrating tomorrow night.
Yay, awesome. That's great. Thank you so much.